was Elizabeth Carter. You'll be the death of me, Peggy Carter.
My brother used to say to me that I was meant to fight.
This isn't what you want.
What is it that you think I want?
The same thing you've wanted since you were a little girl. A life of adventure.
I've grown up. My dream's changed.
No, you've just let everyone else drum them out of you.
I'm afraid I'm simply not cut out for that kind of work.
Fred's a nice enough chap, but be honest. Is he the love of your life? Is this really how you see your future?
What is it?
I know you better than anyone else alive.
Understand that you were the last person to speak to Captain Rogers before his plane went down.
I was.
Could you tell us what he said?
Gentlemen, I'm Agent Carter.
I guess I just don't know why you'd want to join the army if you're a beautiful dame. For a beautiful woman. An agent, not a dame. You are beautiful.
You must have danced.
Figured I'd wait.
For what?
Right part.
Put it down!
No! I can do this!
Because you had a crush.
It wasn't that. I had faith.
Faith, huh?
You're late.
Couldn't call my ride.
I might, even when this is all over, go dancing.
Then what are we waiting for?
The right partner.
Agent Carter, wait.
Looks like finding a partner wasn't that hard after all.
Maybe that's not what you thought it was.
Yes, I think it works.
You're late.
Wait! Go get him.
You're gonna need a rain check on that dance.
A week next Saturday at the Stork Club. 8 o'clock on the dock. Don't dare be late.
We'll have the band play something slow.
Take a step on your...
Steve?
To the captain.
Your line of work requires support.
Everything all right, English?
People who care about your well-being can be there to stitch up your wounds.
If I allow people to get close to me, I'm putting them in danger.
So your solution is to remove yourself from the world you wish to protect. Where's the sense in that?
Maybe some other time.
Didn't mean to disturb you.
No, you didn't disturb me.
No, it's fine. I know a brush off when I see it.
Maybe another time, right?
Sure.
Yeah.
Sure. Another time.
I seem to have a habit of losing people closest to me. Losing is too nice a word. I get them killed. I got him killed, Daniel.
He went into that lab of his own free will.
He was a civilian, a rare bird trying to do right in the world, and I treated him like a soldier.
You used to be fun.
Yeah, once upon a time.
Yeah. I miss him too.
I can assure you I don't do this often. You used me. You lied to me.
I knew how much Steve meant to you because I know how much he means to me. I was protecting you.
Oh, don't pretend this is about me and my emotions.
You were out to protect me. I don't want to see this turmoil that you're in. Look at you.
I trusted you, Howard.
I know.
Peggy.
If I can contain the mess in the rest of your life, the better I'll sleep.
Well, I'll sleep better if you stop pushing me away.
Leaving Dottie with Whitney Frost would have been tantamount to murder, and unlike you, I'm not a murderer, Mr. Jarvis.
And yet everyone around you dies.
Steve. I miss you, Michael.
I'd be here right alongside you if I could, Peggy.
I just wanted a second chance at keeping him safe.
Yes, Mr. Jarvis, there is a cost. One that I have paid for 100 times over. Your wife will survive. You can go on in your life knowing nothing of loss. Lucky you.
Such good taste in secretaries. What's your name, darling?
Agent. We caught a possum earlier this morning. Vicious little creature. Or I have a man stashed in a boot.
Hey, let me out of here!
I managed to stay alive before I met you. I have no idea.
You starved.
Miss. Miss Union Jack. What do you think, fellas? Huh?
Never speak again.
Okay.
What about you and Stark? How do I know you two haven't been fondueing?
Still don't know a bloody thing about women.
He can't even swim.
Will, have you...
He tried to kiss me on VE Day. I knocked him into the Thames. We had to get frogmen to fish him out.
She thinks you're the devil.
My love, you.
Come on. Where's your good boy?
Hey.
How's the good boy?
In the back.
I wonder if I might request a sick day.
What's the matter, got a headache?
Amongst other things. Ladies things.
Oh, jeez. Everybody ready?
I've just thought of something.
We're still attached to a table.
We are still attached to a table. Is that all you've got? Hello?
Captain America, what would I ever do without you?
Why does this keep happening?
What do you mean they lost her?
They said she managed to take down the extra men.
All of them? All the men. You're telling me one woman took out an entire team of highly trained government agents.
You boys play nice. Car trouble.
Crap.
Oh, crap indeed.
shooting, were you, Peggy?
Side by side with Captain America, didn't you?
Yeah. But not as long as she did.
I'll miss you.
Miss you too, Peggy.
I owe you one, pal.
I owe you another one, pal.
To be honest, I've stopped counting, Howard. Miss Carter!
I feel like I already know you.
She hugged. She does not hug.
Take care of yourself. You too, English. How is everything?
Everything is through the first door on your right. You can't miss him.
Hello?
Chief?
Peggy.
You're a genius.
No. But yes.
Ready for another adventure, Mr. Jarvis?
Ready for another adventure, Miss Carter?
You're a good man, Jack. I know that.
Don't get so sentimental. I cry.
Come on, Carter. I owe you a bourbon.
I'll be right there.
I've noticed something of a connection, as it were, between the two of you. I fear that Susan may be losing his composure.
He's just worried about Meg.
As are we all.
No. Chief has a special kind of worry about her.
Please do not do that again.
Get impaled. Yes, Chief.
I think you're in love with her.
I never intended to encourage the affections of two quality suitors, as you say. It simply happened.
You underestimate your allure, Miss Carter. I'm not in the least surprised.
I am.
I'm in this with you till the end, Peggy.
Perhaps if we'd met under different circumstances.
I've learned that dwelling on what might have been, it's no way to live. I'm very happy to have had the chance to know you, Jason.
So am I.
You should have allowed me to be sucked into the rift and shut it down, period. And nothing to say. No quick comeback.
My only regret is that you didn't get to live yours. You saved the world. We rather mucked it up.
You didn't.
Knowing that you helped found S.H.I.E.L.D. was half the reason I stay.
This is S.H.I.E.L.D.
Maybe where it started.
It was a girl.
Strategic Homeland Intervention, Enforcement, and Logistics Division.
And what does that mean to you?
It means someone really wanted our initials to spell out S.H.I.E.L.D.
Sooner or later.
Cap, Agent Carter, they were my heroes growing up.
Margaret Carter was known to most as a founder of S.H.I.E.L.D. But I just knew her as Aunt Peggy. I asked her once how she managed to master diplomacy and espionage in a time when no one wanted to see a woman succeed at either. She said, compromise where you can. Even if everyone is telling you that something wrong is something right. Even if the whole world is telling you to move, it is your duty to plant yourself like a tree, look them in the eye and say no. You move.
When I came out of the ice, I thought everyone I had known was gone. When I found out she was alive, I was just lucky to have her.
She had you back, too.
I know my value. Anyone else's opinion doesn't really matter.
See you, Mark.
Action. Oh. I did that instead of that. Oh, don't.
Sorry.
Don't
have a warrant to search the premises. You may have let Helen Pickens have it. Let's get away.
Well, it's at least you'd contrary the. Anyway, on the case, we've got our scientists to do the exact. I held on to the vital ray detector that was used in Project Rebirth. It should still pick up a reading from whatever truck was used to transport the nitrogen.
She defies categorization.
So does that tie.
One more, same thing.
What does he do? Go that way! Go the other way!
Be who is able to.
Really?
Yes. One more, same thing.
I thought that would hurt more. You're fucking mental. You are insane. Go! No, Mr. Chair! Don't do that!
No noises.
Don't do that!
No noise.
Don't go.
You are seriously mistaken! You're seriously mistaken, unless that's Krispy Kreme. You are seriously. Don't you touch me!